Karibuni sana. Welcome to Daybreak and welcome to Sporty Monday. And then nilikuwa nimewahata maze. It was last week kidogo nilicheka. Unajua mimi ucheka Lulu Saidi pale kwenye Hot 96 na mambo ya kuachilia part B.
Yes.
Last week ilikuwa ngumu sana. Eh, tuseme nilikuwa naendesha na si gari. Lakini Mungu Mungu ni mkuu.
Alikuonekania.
Amenionekania. Well, welcome back. Tuko hapa na Ken Erickson Njeru.
Yes.
Fresh from kutangaza mechi jana usiku.
Yes.
Ako ndani hapa karibu sana.
Kabisa Madagascar.
Madagascar ndo wale wale. Ndio timu yako sasa ya AFCON.
Kumbuka ili timu ilicheza friendly na Harambee. Harambee kashinda 1-0.
Na sahi,
lakini sahi hakuna Harambee. Madagascar iko
wako ndani.
Hakuna Harambee.
Hakuna Harambee. And then also we have Steve Shitera aka Pulisic. Ako hapa ndani. Hazard alishaenda. Ama tukuita Lampard.
No, Pulisic mtamuona because sisi unlike Arsenal wenye wameshindwa kununua Zaha. Sisi tunajua watu we are in this business.
Umeamka tu na ti. Na job. And then John Kianda is going to be joining us in a short while. But of course, it will be remiss of us to start the program if we do not pay tribute and homage to now the late Joe Kadenge, who passed on yesterday. He was aged 84. And we want to just pay tribute to him first. He did so much for football, celebrated, famed for Kadenge na Mpira, and we want to start by paying tribute to the late, great Joe Kadenge.
Joe Kadenge's name has been a prevalent feature in Kenyan football for the past four decades. And the famous phrase, Kadenge na Mpira, was a memorable slogan that was used often during his football heyday in the late 60s and early 70s, when he played for Abaluya United and the Harambee Stars.
For anybody, any upcoming star will remember Kadenge na Mpira.
Kadenge, who passed away at the age of 84 years, experienced the game in all its levels as a player, a coach and an administrator, and was at one point the head coach of the national football team Harambee Stars in 2002. His dribbling skills and ability to hoodwink opponents was legendary during his playing days. Kadenge was also a strong supporter of AFC Leopards and was a common sight in the stands, cheering Ingwe during the league and continental assignments. In the past decade, his health deteriorated and he was hospitalized more than once. In 2016, President Uhuru Kenyatta and the First Lady Margaret Kenyatta visited him at his home in Mariakani, Nairobi, while he was recuperating. Earlier this year, he fell ill and was only allowed back home to recuperate less than 2 months ago.
And in those 1.5 months, it's not been easy. There's been signs that he's becoming okay. As you know, with this journey, especially for somebody like Mze, there are times that you'll see there's some slight improvement, but for today, it was not meant to be. Yeah.
Kadenge's family was inconsolable after having lost another family member earlier this year.
Baba wangu tumemlose. Alikuwa a great man. And then I know everybody anamjua. So tumeacha gap kubwa sana. Sijui tutatoa hiyo gap wapi, lakini gap kubwa sana.
President Uhuru Kenyatta said Kadenge exemplified talent, dedication and patriotism, and condoled with his family. Deputy President William Ruto paid tribute to Kadenge's exploits as a player, saying he terrorized defenders with dribbles, nutmegs, and was a joy to watch. He raised a family of great footballers. ODM leader Raila Odinga said Kadenge's death was a national loss, saying the country had lost one of the greatest talents to ever grace a football pitch in the national uniform. Harambee Stars captain Victor Wanyama condoled with Kadenge's family, tweeting his heartfelt condolences to the family, friends and the football fraternity. Burial plans for the legendary Kenyan footballer will be announced by the family later this week. Bernard Ndong for Citizen TV, Nairobi.
Right, thank you very much, Bernard Ndong, for that story, paying tribute to the late great Joe Kadenge. Maybe just do one round, starting with you, Kianda, your memories of Kadenge.
He was a great footballer, no doubt about that. He had passion for local football, especially when it comes to supporting local talent. And it was humorous. Mm. Anytime you could interview Kadenge, you could see the humor in him. So may his soul rest in peace.
Right.
Yangu si mengi. Enyewe tumepoteza legend pale. Mimi nikimkumbuka na mkumbuka na Kadenge na mpira. Kwa sababu sisi tulikuwa tunadhani mpira ndio Kadenge. Kwa sababu ukikimbia pale hivi mkomo unacheza ile maball pale mtaani, Kadenge na mpira. Sasa ulidhani ile ka mpira ndio Kadenge. Mara ya mwisho ndio unajua venye una ground unajua Kadenge alikuwa player. Tumemuona akichezea timu ya FC Leopards. Pia amesupport sana mpira kwanza kwa Abaluya wakati FC ilikuwa inaitwa Abaluya Group, na akaweza kuwa ana motivate vijana wengi. Kumbuka wale wengi wamecheza kwa soccer, the likes of akina JJ Masika na Sikianga Masiga wakitajwa hapa, Wilberforce, Michael Koth, wote wamepitia kwa mentorship yake Kadenge. Kwa hivyo tumepoteza a legend kwa Kenyan football na African football.
Joe Kadenge is a true definition of a footballer. A footballer who played his heart out with passion. Mara nyingi unakuta sahi football has been commercialized. And these are the people who really decorated our football then. Without money, without pay, but they gave us the best. So as Kadenge rests, I would urge Kenyan footballers to emulate him, because he has built the Kenyan football to where we are, because at his age, you will find him in the stadium watching football matches for Harambee Stars, AFC Leopards. And he brought forth footballers too. We remember Oscar Kadenge, his son, who has also played for AFC Leopards. So a great Kenyan, a legend, rest in peace, Joe Kadenge.